3 weeks after the Kipchumba Murkomen-led Select Committee tabled its report recommending amendments to the Constitution, debate began in the Senate with calls for sobriety in the discussions. The report is, however, likely to rekindle supremacy wars between the Senate and the National Assembly, with some of its recommendations seeking to clip the powers of the National Assembly and share them out with the Senate.
The way we are operating at the moment and looking at our legislative record, in which in the last 3 or so years, only 4 or 5 bills which have gone through the Senate have actually received presidential assent.
Elgeyo Marakwet Senator Kipchumba Murkomen, moving the motion, cautioned the proposed amendments are not meant to undermine the National Assembly, but are geared towards improving services to the people.
Both houses are going to have full legislative mandate, and both speakers must sign a joint certificate before the president can be sure that a bill has been passed properly by parliament.
We agreed unanimously that we would not get into what has been described out there in the press quite wrongly as a superiority debate between the National Assembly and Senate. Our motivation, Madam Speaker, was to protect the institution of Senate.
Murkomen said the Parliamentary Service Commission, as currently constituted, is open to bias, saying they had recommended the commission to be split into two.
The Senate, Madam Speaker, is proposing that we have two service commissions, the service commission that is in charge of the Senate and the service commission that is in charge of National Assembly. The figure and the numbers of people who are representing Senate in the Parliamentary Service Commission is just transferred to the new service commission.
The bill recommends that Senate approves nominees for state offices such as Director of Public Prosecutions, the Chief Justice, Inspector General of Police and Control of Budget, members of constitutional commissions, among others, while the National Assembly will approve nominees directly working for the executive.
We have said that the Senate of the Republic of Kenya will approve their appointments. That includes Director of Public Prosecution, that includes the chair and members of constitutional commissions, the chief justice, the deputy chief justice, the auditor general, inspector general of national police service, and control of budget.
Other proposed amendments include deletion of the clause that ties senators to only legislating on counties, increasing county allocations from the national government to a minimum of 40%. In a scenario where governor, deputy governor, the president or the deputy president have been impeached, one can only seek reprieve from the Supreme Court.
Any person who would like to challenge a removal of a governor or a deputy governor, a removal of president or deputy president, because we have to make it uniform, will have to do so in the Supreme Court and within 60 days.
If the House approves the Select Committee's report, it will pave way for the House to form another committee that will be tasked with drawing up a bill detailing the amendments, as well as have the Senate begin the process of collecting 1 million signatures to fulfill the requirement to have a constitutional amendment through popular initiative.